All right, welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is round two, match four, part two of the HLL IASP charity tournament. We're here with a match between Tango and Big Red One and the Line. We're fighting on Carrington over Town Center once again. I'm here with First Lieutenant Rob.
Hello.
And there is no one else.
Alrighty, well, here we go. First round, pretty exciting, back and forth over Town Center, and we get to run it back on Town Center. Let's see, where do you want to record from this round, Sparrow? You want to take the church this time? I'll take the railroad?
Yeah, I'll take the church this time.
Cool. Alright, let's see if they deviate. It looks like HL Tango is doing a similar opening strategy.
Yeah.
Three tanks up. Or sorry, bigger one, similar opening strategy with three tanks and their troop transport.
Same,
push into the point.
Same thing here with Tango. They seem to have two tanks and a supply truck just going down that main road. It looks like their plan will be to get a garrison onto ruins, a garrison north of ruins, and they're going to have already hitting the crossroads on that road just where there's like a bit of a courtyard with like a bus stop. Like that area.
We're off. So it looks like HL Tango is going to attempt to take towns. I actually like what it looks like they're doing this time. They're sending their troop transport up the middle, but it looks like they're going to actually try to get a garrison on the south side of the Town Center. Maybe to try to approach it from that railroad side instead of trying to come up the main road where all that artillery fire is going to be blasting.
Yeah, I see it. I also see a tank of some sort. I can't tell if it's the recon or medium tank.
Likely Panther.
And I see a transport truck going on that crossroads, but looks like Big Red One is going to be first to the point here.
Yep, Big Red One was able to navigate the artillery, and they're once again quick to the point.
Ruins is getting pounded right now as a tank is passing through. Oh, did they take out... What happened to the supply truck? The supply truck got stuck for Tango here, it looks like. They flipped it. That's no good.
That is a tough thing to recover from as bigger one starts to storm in right around the same time as Tango is getting there. Looks like bigger one will have the early advantage here with numbers.
Yeah, Big Red One's strategy of just having a bunch of small squads kind of creates a Zerg effect wherever they decide to go, placing their OPs like little spawn eggs to just swarm a point. There is a tank from Tango pushing onto the point now, along with a tank from Big Red One.
It looks like Big Red One has a pretty commanding presence on point as HL Tango tries to regroup and get themselves pushed in. Meanwhile, armor from Big Red One coming in behind the bulk of the HL Tango's push.
Yeah, this should be interesting here. Ruins is a much easier point to attack than Customs is. So it should be interesting to see how Tango deals with that.
The difference being, though, is that since Ruins is right on top of Town Center, HL Tango is going to be able to play their offense while playing defense, which I think always gives a pretty significant advantage for the team trying to cap that middle point. Because now they don't necessarily have to commit quite as many forces to their defense, and it forces any assault on the Ruins to really have to take those wide flanks. And here we go with the first flip as Tango uses the cap race against Big Red One, and Big Red One takes control of Town Center.
it seems like all of the action today is going to be centered around this town center and ruins point. Which is great for us, it makes it easy to record.
Right. I'm gonna rotate towards ruins if you want. I'm gonna look at town center from behind ruins if you wanna look at town center from like the far side of ruins, if you know what I mean.
Yeah. So I'm looking 300 into the point right now.
Yep, and I'm looking 65 so I can see what's going on from ruins perspective. Like HL Tango, is something going on that. Far left flank. On the custom side. Now side. There's a pretty brutal fight for the church. Seems like HL Tango's actually giving up some space in the middle as they try to hit town center from either flank.
Yeah, they've more or less like tried to pinch her onto the point. They've set up a red zone garrisons near the factory and E4 keypad 3, and they're just trying to push in, swarm and push into the point as much as possible.
You know, it'd be really cool. I think they should consider adding is if they made it so the neutral point was locked out for the first 10 minutes.
The neutral,
the opening neutral point, you couldn't actually cap for the first 10 minutes. It's just locked.
That would make, that'd be really hard.
Well, it would actually force a fight over the neutral point, right? So it's like, you couldn't just get in there and quick cap it. You'd actually have to fight over it for that first 10 minutes until someone could actually cap it.
That could fix some of the biases if you did a lockout like that. With some of these maps, because you know, with this map you could say the Germans have an advantage because they have much more of a straight road right into town center, and that could be argued for, but something like that, even if you did like 5 minutes, it would greatly reduce the amount of emphasis it means to actually get to town center first.
Yeah, which I think would make the game a little more interesting. It's a little bit of a bummer when, you know, now with the meta changes, it's not quite the end-all be-all. It used to be capping the first point because you can't.
Ooh, we just got a big, there was a tank battle going on between, it looks like a Panther and a Sherman of some sort. Can't tell if it was a 76 or not. Just battling it out just south of town center. The Panther tank... Tiger seems to have won. I can't really tell what it is from all the way up here. It's a Panther.
And meanwhile, Big Red One doesn't seem to be putting much pressure on ruins. They're really focused. Seem to be focusing more on the defensive as HL Tango tries to construct their way around.
Yeah, Tango's done a really good job in engulfing this point, but they do have the better weapons for this kind of fighting. So, it'd be interesting to see if they can capitalize on that.
Yeah, Big Red One has proven that they are really successful at getting to the point quick, which is still just such a huge advantage. Just being able to get there both rounds, good, you know. 30 seconds to a minute before HL Tango can make all the difference.
That's for sure.
However, it does look like map control advantage is in the HL Tango's favor as they have pressure on all entry points into town center. Yeah, now if you're Big Red One, you're thinking, well, all it takes is a loss of a garrison or two and we might be in trouble.
Oh, what the heck?
What's up?
Something's acting up here. I'm gonna check my recording. Okay, I'm still recording. Sorry about that. I don't know what happened to my screen. It kept, like, flickering quite a bit. I'm not sure what that was all about. This is probably one of the closer matches we've seen all weekend.
Yeah, looking at the map, BR1 really has every single one of their outposts on point and no garrisons anywhere near the point. So all it takes is, you know.
We got a bombing run in here. That's from Tango. It looks like. Go ahead.
Wasn't able to wipe any outposts with the armor on point.
Yeah, it was right over the. Got a bombing run from BR1 in the line in response on top of ruins.
And it did take out some troops, but no one in the vicinity for BR1 to really capitalize on that bombing run. Yeah, I would say BR1 right now is probably looking to try to get garrison a little closer to point, because like I said, all it takes is Tango's able to find a way to win those gunfights and get into the point and just start wiping a couple of outposts. BR1 doesn't really have any quick response. They're all pretty far away as far as their spawns.
Yeah, it looks like Tan and Carnado are trying to push onto that alley house again. If they are able to get to that alley house and place a satchel, that could spell the end of this BR1 defense.
Yeah, meanwhile, BR1's not even putting any significant pressure onto the point. They only have a one officer AT combo trying to even assault with some recon elements.
Yeah, we've got a two-prong attack here from Tango. One's coming in more from the church, the other is coming from the German approach into town center.
Actually, it looks like BR1 might have lost some of their outposts on point with but now they do have a garrison established on the point itself as well.
Is it on that alley house?
Yeah, it's on the alley house. The alley house is the only point that they maintain. It looks like HL Tango has been able to successfully take the church side.
Yeah, they've been placing their stuff there. This is honestly an instance where I would have Artie just start pounding the alley house. I feel like with a little bit of map knowledge, if you know that they don't have, if you know they have a garrison on point, there's only really one of two places on town center that they could have it. And that's the alley house or the corner house. And they've taken the corner house, so they know it's not there.
Meanwhile, BR1 seems to be placing a second squad on the assault as they start to make their way into ruins.
Yeah. Got a recon plane going over. We have a garrison on ruins that's lighting up hot every so often, but Tango's got auxiliary several ruins outposts. But they're both, two of them are hot. One just went down out of the four they got on defense.
Yeah, not much massive forces, just, you know, kind of maybe squad on squad elements kind of duking out over the ruins. Neither team seems ready to commit any significant force to either assaulting or defending their ruins. Now it looks like, what do we think, HL Tango was dropping smoke rounds in onto town center?
I don't know if it's, I would imagine it's them because it's only helping them right now, but it seems like BR1's own Artie is going in in response. Or grenades. It could be either one at this point.
Yeah, I'm just seeing swaths of people go down in town center, oh man.
We're seeing cap progress towards Tango. They have mostly pushed on to point. There's only really three members of Big Red One on point right now. All they need to do is take the corner house, which only had one spawn on it. So something's up with the Big Red One guys right now. Oh, never mind. Here's the big spawn wave. And most of Tango's push got taken out.
It looks like that armor on point for Big Red One is putting in work, giving them the space they need.
This moment of silence is brought to you by me pitching an idea for maybe something we can show on the 7th Cav YouTube channel. Defense point. We go over a single point on each of the maps and describe how best to defend it using insight from several of our Cav members. What do you think?
I think already you can kind of get into that. I mean, you know, once you watch, you know, is it four games of some of the best teams playing over the same strong point, it becomes very clear what the patterns of control are for each point.
Yeah, but not everybody has 45 minutes to watch around. I'm talking about 10-minute condensed videos here.
Yeah, I think we're going to try to put together some kind of highlight reel at the end of the tournament. See if we can do like a good 10-15-minute highlight reel of some of the best footage we got.
All right, Paul, get that satchel in there. You're so close. Ah, and he's dead. Taken out by Dark Caesar. Looks like a satchel did go off near the point. I don't know if that's taken out the garrison or not.
No, it doesn't seem like it did much damage.
I can imagine Tango being desperate to try something. I feel like they know exactly where they're at.
Yeah, HL Tango seems like they're trying a new approach from the ruin side. You know, honestly, I almost feel like it would be best just to try to hit that alley house, right? Like, they're going in from the church direction. Which, you know, fair enough. That's where they've had most success trying to get into town center. But, you know, committing a good squad size element to try to lock down the alley house from the alley house direction. Get a satchel in there. It's just something. I think Big Red One's also done a really fantastic job just shutting down artillery both rounds. I don't think HL Tango's been able to really get any kind of effective artillery usage.
Tango's had their artillery taken out. Big Mac's going to take out the Ardeon Big Red One side.
Yeah. Meanwhile, we have Aslan. Looks like he might have an opportunity here, as there's not much focus from Big Red One watching the alleyway. Oh, looks like maybe they just have that one MG really locking down that roadway.
Paul here looking to make a move back onto that corner house, it looks like.
Yeah, meanwhile, he's getting artillery fire coming danger close. His bigger one actually has a request for artillery fire right on his head, more or less.
To be fair, that's probably the biggest threat to them right now is another satchel charge near their garrison and OP.
Absolutely.
And it looks like Tango is slowly but surely trying to make their way up the alleyway.
Was not able to get past that constant MG fire.
Ooh, oh, and they're taking out the MG. Oh. Here's the push. Now the question here is, does Pull have the right class? It looks like he's placed down a satchel because he's running back now.
Meanwhile, we get a semi-effective bombing run on point from BR1. It's taking out two, three, four.
Oh, and here's a bombing run from Tango on point.
Yeah, that satchel charge just went up. That satchel charge wasn't able to wipe out the garrison on point.
It was or was not?
It was. However, the outpost seemed to be unaffected.
Ah, so they just gotta get on point now. Which honestly just requires a suicide run from someone. Which looks like Assailant is going to be the man here.
Assailant just wiped about two OPs, maybe three outposts from Big Red 1.
Oh, he's taking out the SL on point. Is that all the OPs on point?
There's still three surrounding OPs, but they've completely taken control of the alley house. Huge play from HL Tango. Good move from Pol and Aslan securing that alley house.
For Narnia. Alright.
Yeah, right.
I support you, Lion Jesus.
It'll be interesting to see now if. Oh, they. To see if they're able to capitalize here, HL Tango, now that they've locked out the garrison and a large number of the outposts on that side.
It doesn't look like it. It looks like they're a bit too far to respond effectively to it. Which is unfortunate because that was a huge play that could have really made the difference.
Yeah, I'm not sure where the bulk of HL Tango's forces are now. They have about one squad on point.
They've got a
coming from the north.
Yeah, they've got a huge push from the street over where the bus stop is coming onto the point now, and then they've got people on the other side of it.
Yeah, meanwhile it looks like Brad One's dropping the supplies to start reestablishing the alley house garrison.
Yeah, and that's the thing about Big Red 1's strategy is that if you don't take out all their OPs too, they just come back with a vengeance.
I mean, Big Red 1, you know, they're running 3-4-man squads. Not like they're running a bunch of like 2-mans like they did the first round.
And Big Red 1 is more or less taken back over this point in force.
Yeah, but HL Tango was able to force them to recondense, which might give them the chance to reconstrict, and if they're able to get up, now they know, you know, Pol and Aslan kind of know they can get up that alleyway and get some effective pressure. Be interesting to see if they continue to try to capitalize on that approach.
I mean, it worked once, it can work again.
Yeah, meanwhile, Big Red 1 really has not tried any kind of significant pressure this round onto Ruin. Seems like they're pretty content to just hold town center. Looks like BR1 might have just won a couple of key gunfights on point at ruins. Might have knocked out an outpost or two. We might actually see some effective pressure from BR1 on the ruins.
I'm not too sure. Tango still has about 3 OPs up. It looks like they've spotted an enemy red zone garrison in C6 keypad 1.
Yeah, that's where the main push is coming now from Big Red One, trying to get in on the point. Getting close to that 1 hour mark. Looks like this is going to end with a no mercy rule, so we will be playing it out. It's going to be another very tight match. See if HL Tango isn't able to squeeze something out here.
Yeah, it's been very close. It's a very heated battle over town center. These teams are fairly evenly matched, it may seem.
Seems that Big Red One is actually starting to commit more forces to the attack. Now they have about 2 squad sized elements, maybe 3, actually really starting to put pressure on the ruins.
It'll be interesting to see if it actually does anything. It seems like Tango has a pretty strong hold over ruins right now.
Right now, Tango really only has 3 with a probably first spawn coming here shortly on the point. As we get cap progress on ruins from Big Red 1.
Yeah, so here we go.
But it's really not even, you know, right now the map control is in HL Tango's favor for the ruins strong point. They don't have really much to any personnel, maybe 3 or 4 troopers in the vicinity of ruins.
Yeah, I'm gonna rotate over to ruins a little bit.
And BR1 coming in with armor support on ruins, this could be enough to really shift the balance. I think Tangos might have to start thinking about reacting. Even though Hunter XR seems to maybe be able to finish his Panther.
A lot of pop-in stuff that we just don't see being so high up in the sky that you forget that there are walls in some places.
True. Looks like HL Tango's trying to reinforce in on the ruins as BR1 currently has some pretty significant map control on the ruins.
That is for sure. We got complaints of lag from Tango, but nothing we can really do about that.
Yeah, this is true. If you even look at the ping comparison, poor guys on Tango have, 180-ish pings, where most of the guys on BR1 are working at 20 or 50. So in a very competitive environment like this, that can make a big difference.
For sure.
You might actually see the ruins go to the go in BR1's favor. Is Tango placed to reinforce?
Not yet, but they don't have the manpower to do it.
Yeah, it looks like BR1 might get the ruins here. It looks like it's gonna happen. And there it goes.
Damn.
We'll have to see what Tango can do if they can once again get control.
Is that a recon element on Placot? Who's on that last point?
Yes. Yes, you can alert them that the cap is a recon element, so it is a fair cap. So they will have to defend that.
Got a bombing run from Big Red One right now. Big bombing run from Tango onto ruins as they start to make cap progress on back on it. But they may have to have more people respond to this situation on Placot because it looks like they might lose it to recon.
I don't know. Is HL Tango sending anyone in that direction?
They've got a whole looks like two squads responding to it. They've got a single squad on it.
Meanwhile, Big Red One puts a reinforce on the ruins as HL Tango starts to recapture the zone.
Admin fourth, what the f
What's up?
Lipton's just saying admin fourth, WTF.
Looks like, ooh, it looks like Big Red One might actually win the cap with just recon. And that's game.